just come to the conclusion that everyone in this room is trustable?
Yeah. Yes, of course. Yes, absolutely.
But, Ida, why are you sitting on the floor?
Because it's rude to have your guests sit on the floor.
Okay.
So, what's your name?
My name's Clementine. I'm kind of an old secret friend of Cymbeline. She would occasionally come and visit me at the border.
And you say that you can somehow get into people's minds?
It's more of manipulation. I can kind of control people's thoughts, and even memories.
Stop. Please don't speak anymore.
Why?
We can't talk about this with a seventh person in the room.
Sloane, you're starting to sound like Margaret with that speech that she does. She doesn't just come out and say something.
I think I can help.
You have to do what I say. Do not open your eyes, no matter what. Whatever you hear or see, don't open them until I say so.
Okay.
You can open your eyes now.
What did you do?
I made her dormant. It will only last for around an hour, but under that time, she won't be able to hear or see us, and we can talk about anything without her knowledge.
Are you saying that we can find up a way to get rid of her without her knowing?
Yes. We only have an hour, so we probably better get started.
It's so great to finally meet you. An honor, really. It's great. I've heard so much about you, from everyone. All good things, of course. You don't have to act like I'm royalty. I'm about as far from royalty as a snail is to a bear.
Really?
Well, that's the exact opposite of what I've been hearing from the girls. They all really look up to you, especially Emma. She's constantly saying that she wants to be like you.
That's really great.
Ellen, I am so sorry. I shouldn't have said anything.
Oh, it's all right. I just need to move on from the fact.
You found her yesterday. You're not going to move on within a day. You need to spend as much time with her as you can. I know you can't make up for lost time. But you can't dwell in the past either.
You're right.
I can't. It's just sickening to think that I didn't know her. I didn't think I knew her. I had completely forgotten her. And yet, Emma was suffering for almost 6 years.
Have you girls come up with anything?
Yes, actually. How about you?
We've been discussing things, and we've came up with some pretty good ideas for what's to come.
Would you like to hear any of them?
Of course I would. I just need to talk to you about something first.
You see, we think that we need something. This thing, and apparently it was used to enchant the amethyst. And I think it can take care of all of our problems. I think it can bring everyone back. And we can start up the town again. A new town. And I also think it can help us with Margaret.
Do you know what this thing is, or
or where we could find it?
Well, it's, we know it's called, a flower, and apparently it's being, at the moment, possessed by a family.
Do you know who they are?
The last name is Stone, and apparently they live in Willow Creek. It's just half an hour from here.
No, I don't feel comfortable with barging in and taking someone else's own property. There must be another way.
But Mom, this might be your only option. We haven't gotten a chance like this. Ever. We have never gotten a chance like this. This might be your only chance to fix everything. And we won't be barging in and taking it. We'll ask them, and if they refuse, we'll try to find another way. But I believe it could work.
We don't even have the amethyst anymore. We never even had it. How is this flower supposed to help that?
If the flower was used to enchant the amethyst to give it its power, then I think the flower might have similar properties. It would have to.
Ellen, she does have a point. It may hold the same properties. See? Maya agrees. If there were another way to have gotten the amethyst back, would have you done it? Another way to get it into Connet, other than having to leave?
Of course. We had no idea what was outside of there. We had no idea what was on the other side of the wall.
If there would have been another way, of course I would have taken it.
Mom, I care just as much about Connet as you do. You know that. Would you do whatever it takes to get them back?
You're right. We do need to try all of our options.
Okay. I'll go find their number and get a hold of them to see if they want to talk. Thank you. Thank you so much. And I promise, if this doesn't work out, I'll take the blame.
Of course. It's the least I could do for not being there.
Just think, you came home just in time for my birthday next week. We can make it the best it's ever been.
I'll make sure it's the best one you have ever had. I promise. Are you mad at me or something?
No. Why would I be?
Really? Our conversations have been very sparse since we got back from... Well, you don't really like to talk about it.
Cindy, could we please just forget about that? About that whole situation?
Chris, some things are etched into your brain. You can't forget it, all right? You can't forget a whole year.
Could we please not talk about this here? In front of all these people?
What's the difference about talking about this? We're going to be talking about things we probably shouldn't be talking about around these people anyways later.
Because the people later won't remember anything.
Excuse me. We were, just... Well, you see, we were just getting ready for a play. You're not actually going to forget anything. Not until you leave the building.
Ugh.
airy. Let's get out of here.
It was nice meeting you.
See what you did?
My fault. Do I look like I can do that? I just tattletailed on what you did.
And you still haven't answered my question?
Fine. I'm still upset that we never got to say goodbye. Is that what you wanted to hear?
You mean Spark and Sapphire, aka our great aunt and our grandmother?
I know they are that, but I really don't consider them that. They're more sisters than anything.
Yeah. I guess you're right. Hello. Are you by any chance Chrysanthemum Stone?
Yes. It's lovely to meet you, Alan. I'm Chrysanthemum, yes. You can call me Chris for short, though. Hey, I'm Maya. I'm the one you spoke over the phone with.
It's lovely to meet you, too.
I'm Emma, Ellen's daughter.
It's great to meet you all.
We should get down to business. Now, I learned quite a bit of information over the phone with Maya, and I've given it a lot of thought. Now, the stones and the flower both mean the world to me. I wouldn't know what to do if anything ever happened to them. So I'm not willing to give them up to a complete stranger. But I do have somewhat of an agreement I've thought of.
A deal, you mean?
I come with the flower. If you need it, I'll bring it to you. You are allowed to use it, but only if I have watch on it.
Emma, you brought us here. It's your choice. Whatever you want.
I think I accept it. If you coming with it is the only option, I think we should take it. It's honestly a very, very good chance this could work.
I accept.
What are you planning to do with it?
Well, the amethyst. It's something that's very, very important to our people. My family, everyone who knows about it. And the flower was used to enchant the amethyst. And it also was given to your family. Its original owner was the one who used it to enchant the amethyst and also created reflections. I think if the flower was used to enchant the amethyst to give it its power, I think the flower might have some of the same properties. And we might be able to get the amethyst back in some way or form. I think it could help all of our problems. Really, I do.
Stop.
What? Are we there? Cymbeline, you start digging where this stick is.
Why do I have to dig?
You volunteered to hold the shovel.
I didn't realize that was going to put me on digging duty.
Is the digging for something, or are you just putting her to work? I buried something a few months ago. It's something I think can help us.
Huh? Clementine, I think I found something.
That's it.
This is an old journal of mine. The journal itself isn't important for what's going on right now, but what's inside of it is. It's a fragment of the amethyst. It was given to my ancestor by Connet. She was told to guard Connet and to make sure that nothing ever happened to it. When it was given to her, she was given the power to be able to see between worlds, and whoever it's passed down to gains that power. My whole family was able to. If that's a fragment, can't it do the same thing as the real amethyst? Unfortunately, no. It doesn't have the full power of the amethyst, just a tiny bit. It can only be used once, really. That is, going between worlds. You can only go between worlds once with this. Its main purpose is granting power. If we can get this flower, could we use that to enchant the fragment to make it be able to do what the actual amethyst can? That's what I'm hoping.